guys, it's Sasha, and today I'm here to do a review on The Scorpio Trials by Maggie Stellwater. I wanted to do more reviews as part of my 2016 reading goals or reading resolutions. I'm not sure exactly what I titled my video, but I want to do at least two reviews a month, so this is going to be review one. Who knows what I will be reviewing next? Let's get to the reviewing part. This will be a spoiler-free review. I came by this book, I won a Tumblr giveaway, and the reason why I picked this book, I had a pick of any book, but the reason why I picked this book is because it had been on my TBR for a little while, and I've been hearing a lot about Maggie Stellwater from her Raven Cycle series, right? A lot of good things about that, and I didn't pick that up because I'm not really into that storyline, but I figured I'd pick up one of her other books, plus it's been on my wishlist for a little while now. The Scorpio Races is about a girl named Puck, aka Kate Connolly, who joins in the races, even though they're primarily for men. And Puck is riding in the races for reasons of her own to help save her family. And she meets this boy named Sean. I'm not sure if it's pronounced Sean or Sean because it's spelled C-E-A-N, and I would think of that as Sean, but of course some people pronounce it as Sean. So I'm gonna pronounce it as Sean because that's just how I imagined his name would be pronounced. Sean has won the Scorpio races in the last 4 years. He's a quiet, sort of mysterious character. Puck doesn't really know a lot about him, and he's a loner, he keeps to himself. So the Scorpio races is about Sean and Puck, but the Scorpio races, which is, it's a race about water horses. They're sort of like horses, when I imagine them, I sort of think of seahorses anyway, but I know they're shaped like regular horses, but they're more faster, they're more dangerous, they will eat people, they'll eat other horses, they're very vicious, and the sea is always calming to them, so you really have to tame them, and the races are very dangerous because a lot of people end up dying. So I came into this book with medium expectations. I really wasn't sure what I was going to get because I've heard plenty of good things about Maggie Stellwater, but I've not read any of her books. This is my first book This is the first book I've read by her. I found the book to be more character-driven, especially in the beginning. I was wondering where the plot was going, and I was slightly annoyed by that because I felt like it was dragging out, but the beginning was a little annoying for me. The middle part and the end were, I felt, really great, and I will get to that later in this stamp. Things I liked Puck. I liked her brother Finn, and I also liked her brother Gabe as well. I liked how she struggled with her emotions throughout this book and how she grew as a character. I also like how Sean grew as a character. In fact, I felt all the characters grew in this book. I was really pleased with that. I felt it was really good. I liked how Maggie Stellwater had the mythology and how the water horses weren't like regular creatures. I really liked that part of the book. I thought it was very interesting, especially since she just took certain parts of the mythology and made it her own. I thought that was really unique. I really liked the end of this book. The end of the book had me wishing for another book. Even though it's not really needed, I almost wanted to know more about the characters. I didn't want to leave the world. In fact, when I put this book down, I was wandering around wondering what next book I could pick up to make me feel a little better. I was confused about what book I wanted to read, even though I have so many books that I need to read on my shelves. So I guess that says something about how good this book is and how much I liked it. I liked how they had a little bit of romance, but you know, it wasn't overpowering and it wasn't smothering. You sort of knew it was going to happen, but it was still like very subtle. The romance in this was really cute to me anyway. I really enjoyed it. It really fulfilled me, okay? Another thing I like, can we talk about this cover? This is a Scholastic UK edition that I got off the Book Depository because the Tumblr giveaway won it on. I specifically asked for this edition because it is so beautiful. The red and the black and the font and all of this, it's really beautiful. This plot was more character driven, so the plot in the beginning went really slowly for me. I didn't really like Puck in the beginning, to be honest. I felt she was sort of selfish and, you know, which she was. She was selfish, and obviously she grew throughout the story, as I've said before, and I liked her more. This book gave me a lot of feels. I would recommend it to lovers of Maggie Stellwater, fantasy lovers. It has some romance in there. It has romance in there, so romance lovers. I also recommend this to YA lovers, because this was a really nice YA book. Yep, so that's all for now. I hope you liked this review, because there'll be more reviews to come, so check out all my other videos.